tried to get yourself upgraded on a flight? Most of us have given it a shot, and unfortunately, most of us have never managed it. Mm. But one influencer has managed to pull it off. Check this out.
Moon boot. I'm just
going to
put this on a little bit.
Are you going to wear that on the plane?
Yeah.
No way.
No, why would I do that? Can you help
me?
He joins us now. It's good to see you, Jamie.
Thank you. Likewise.
Hey, you paid $20 for that ankle brace.
I did.
Why did you not keep up the charade the whole way? Why did you take it off as soon as you got upgraded?
I kind of forgot. Like, I was enjoying the business class too much to sort of remember that, to wear it the whole time. So, yeah, I guess it worked.
So it did actually work.
It did actually work.
You're not just fooling us.
Yes.
You did. Really? When you took it off, you didn't get pulled back.
No. I think they kind of just forgot that the reason I was in business class is because of that. So, yeah, they're really nice. The Cathay Pacific staff were great. So, shout out to them, you know. I'll be flying them many times in the future if they still allow me to.
How many followers has this gone out to? How many followers do you have in the social media world?
So, I have a total of about 8.5 million across all platforms. So, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat. I'm big on MySpace as well, Bebo, MSN, so...
Is MySpace still a thing?
Yeah, I'm pretty big on that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is this just an ad for the airline that you flew?
No, I wish it was. If they go, if they want to sponsor me,
let
me know. No, it's not. Unfortunately,
the reason I'm a bit with Sarah, I'm a bit cynical about it too. That's because we're journos. But just can we watch this bit?
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
So you walk off absolutely fine, and they're like, "See you. I hope your ankle's better."
I mean, it was
that makes me think. Yeah, well done, Cathay Pacific. Good ad.
I mean, if they want to use it as an ad, I give full permission, just credit me. But at the end of the day, the staff were great and, you know, I guess he just saw my face, what he remembered, so he didn't really look at my ankle again.
Did you feel bad?
I mean, how many times has everyone, like, in the world trying to, you know, upgrade to business class or looked up on the internet how to get something for free? You know, I'm sure we've all done it. Let's not lie here.
So where did you get the idea?
I don't know. I just kind of, like, get ideas from random places, like when I'm having a shower or, like, you know, those sorts of places, and it just came to me one day.
What do you say to people? Because some people have been really outraged by this. I think it's kind of genius. Some people are saying it's criminal that you did this. What do you say to them?
I think that, like, people should just learn to take a joke. I mean, it's 2020. I feel like society is becoming quite sensitive to everything. And I feel like, you know, I imitated a broken ankle, which I've actually personally had before. So it's like, if you can't take a simple joke, then I feel sorry.
You caused a bit of a stir at the Australian Open as well.
I did.
Should we have a look at that?
Mm.
Sure.
Was that for free tickets?
No, it wasn't.
You were kicked out.
I did get kicked out, but me and Nick Kyrgios are friends after that, so I think he enjoyed it.
Are you about to prank us?
No, like you guys gave me like half an hour notice, so I didn't have time to think of anything in the car. I was going to bring my boot on, but I've actually packed it for tomorrow's flight.
Oh, you have not? Do you carry it around?
Of
best 20 bucks you've ever spent.
100%. It's like, I've got like a fold-up boot now, so I've got in my backpack usually.
What else do you reckon you can do with the boot?
A lot of things.
What other good things in life could come out of this prank?
I mean, there are a lot of good things in life. I'm sure we could all figure something out to maybe put on the show. Just message me.
So you're very odd.
I just find it odd that it's not, you know, I can take a joke. I think everyone, you can see the humor in it. I was like, great, you got away with it. It's just, I just feel bad that you were playing on the sympathy of the staff of the airline, and they did it because they felt sorry for you, tried to make your life easier. That's where I'm coming from. Hey, good for you. But at the same time, I don't mind that you kind of stole an upgrade in a way.
Oh, but what about other people who are like, oh, don't you know who I am to get upgrades?
Yeah, well, like Harris, we're not all you.
Is that what you do?
I've never done that. Well, maybe people who fake being engaged or honeymooners or something like that.
Look, I think,
I hate the game.
I think the bottom line...
get an upgrade that way.
Really?
I think the bottom line is...
Only.
All of us would love to be in business class, but pay for economy, and there are all, I guess, ways where you can do that. Some people choose to do it as, you know, my luggage is too big, or I'm pregnant, or it's my anniversary, but I chose to use a boot, and I guess it worked, so.
Yeah.
Don't hate the player, hate the game. Jamie Zhu, thanks for joining us.
Thanks, guys.